In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of post API call using GetX library. So if you have gone through our channel, there is a complete playlist on GetX tutorials here. So here we have made use of GetX library and have performed various tasks here. So we have seen various examples like displaying an alert box, state management, navigating in between different screens, bottom sheet, and network call event. So in terms of network call, we have only dealt with get API request, and today I am going to deal with post API request using GetX library. So post API call is a bit different from get API call here, and we even need to pass some parameters in post API call, and also sometimes we require headers. So in this part of the tutorial, let us try to see in detail like how to make a post API call using GetX library. So stay tuned till the end, and even if you are having any queries regarding the post API call, all those things will be solved in this particular tutorial. So let's start with this particular tutorial now. So let's get started with this particular tutorial now. So the very first thing here we need to add is like get dependency here. So I have added the get library under the dependency, and the latest version is like 4.6.5 now. So you can just update this particular library according to the latest available. And let's tap on pubget here, or through the terminal also you can just run the command so that your getx library will be added to your code here. So now let's get started with the basic tutorial now. So importing material.dart and void main. And now let us try to specify our first class, that is my app. And this is of a type stateless here. So let's make use of a stateless widget and name it like my app here. And instead of container, let us try to return material app, and inside which let us try to specify scaffold now. So very quickly I'm just going through this particular coding, because this is all the basic coding which we deal almost in every application. So with the help of a text widget, let us specify like getx post API call, and also try to make this as constant. And inside the body, let us try to specify a text button directly. And in the text button now, we do have two mandatory things which we need to specify in the text button. So the first one is on press here, and for now I'm just leaving it as empty. And next one is child, and using which we can just specify a text widget again, and there we can just specify fetch data. So now we are going to fetch the particular data here by making use of an API call, and that is of a type post API call here. So this is it, the basic structure we have done for our tutorial. And now let's try to create a method from where we can make a post API call. So if you have seen here, we have added a get library to our project, and now let's try to import it now. So import, when you start typing get here, you will be getting get connect. Whenever you are dealing with network calls here using GetX library, so get connect is the import which you need to make here. So as per the latest version of GetX library, this is the way we deal with the API calls. So now let's try to create a variable now. So let us try to create final, and I am trying to name it like GetX here, and this is of a type get connect. Okay, so just we have created getx a variable here of a type getConnect, and now we will be making use of this getx and try to make our post API call. So let us start creating our method here, void fetch data, and this is of a type asynchronous. So every time an API call is made, it is of a type asynchronous itself. And here we are not returning anything. You can just clearly see here, this is not of a type future here. So I'm just specifying void here, that's all. So now let us try to capture the response by making an API call here. So final response is equal to getx, which we have specified above dot. And now you can get a set of methods here you can make use of it. So here you do have a get API call here, and you do have a post, patch, put, all these things, and even you do have delete here. So for updating data, we make use of patch here. So I think you are aware of this, and if required in coming tutorials, we'll also be dealing with this particular patch API call as well. So here are the list of API call tutorials in Flutter we have dealt with. So I'm just adding the playlist link in the description section below. You may go through it if interested. So now let's try to add the URL first. So this is the URL by using which I will post my data. So for this particular URL, I will be posting my data and trying to fetch the output. So now here you are also able to see undefined name body. So we need to specify body here, because as this is a post API call, we need to send some parameters. So now let us try to declare final data equal to, and within which let us try to specify our parameters which we want to pass to our post API call. So the very first thing I want to pass is like name here and user type, and let us enclose this inside the user type, and I'm going to specify this like admin. Okay, so this is my data here, and for the body I'm going to append this one data. So that's it. It's so simple. That's it. We have specified a URL, and for which we have specified even data here. So this will be posted to that particular URL. And now we need to track the response, right? So there are various ways we can just track the response, but here I'm just going to print the response here. So whenever you are trying to make use of a print statement here, it's a very good practice to enclose it in this way, because whenever you release this application to live, then the data will not be printed, and it also adds a level of security to your code here. So let us try to specify it in a different way. Response dot then here. So we do have a method like then, and here you can see this is the value which is being received in terms of response here. And now we can make use of a print statement here, and you can just specify value here, and this will work now. Value dot body here, and try to save the code, and now tap on the fetch data here, and you can see here, and you can see here we have got the output like name Abhi and user type admin. So whatever we specify in the post data here to this particular API, we are getting the same in response, stating that our data is being created. And also you can see here we have got the exact timestamp when we have created this particular data, and also an ID here. So let's try to change the data and try to save it, and here you can see we have got the ID like 163 now. And let us try to call the API call again, and here you could see like ID is 589. So we are just making use of a dummy API call here and trying to post the data, and I'm trying to show you the response even, such that the post API call is made successful, and also we have received a response in return. So this is the way we can implement a post API call in GetX library. So the main important aspect is like get connect here. So making use of this particular get connect class here, we can make use of networking API calls in GetX library, API calls in GetX library. Not only adding a data here, we do require some additional parameters. So just tap on the post here, and you could clearly see here you can also pass the headers now. So if you are having any headers in your API call, you need to send them. So simply just specify headers here, and within which you can specify your headers. And also you do have content type here. So sometimes you require like application/json, application/text, or some image you want to upload. So all these things, you can just make use of the content type here. And also the main aspect sometimes we do require is called like encoding. So you do also need to add encoding in your post API call here. And in our coming tutorial, I will be clearly showing you how to make encoding of your post API call. And if you are having any queries in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below, and the code for this tutorial I am providing in the description section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.